So now it came in the days before the war. The political conception, I will explain it, which assumed that Sadat would not attack due to political calculation, collapsed. Dayan was the only one who had all the information, the military information and the information about the political channels and the skill and the experience to analyze it. And he made it very, very good. On May, he said, gentlemen, prepare for a war during the second half of this summer. Excellent. But 4 months later, Dayan had quite different picture. And he said, it's 12 days before the war. The military tension was in air. And Dayan said, there is a reason to think that the Arab states would now prefer another political round rather than a military round. No doubt, low probability for war because of political calculation. And one more. Dayan, on the October 1st, 5 days before the war, Dayan to the Army Chief of Staff after giving an intelligence outline of Egyptian and Syrian troops. The Arabs talk and talk, but they don't fire a lot. That happens sometimes. On the way to peace, or at least not to renew the war, I expect that there will be a kind of ebbing of hostilities or not active fanning of the flames. Very, very clear. Dayan knew that Kissinger was preparing to lead a political process after the election in Israel. And I was surprised to find, based on the document, that Dayan prepared to lead a political process after the election in Israel, which would be based on Sadat initiative and Kissinger outline. Dayan based his position on the intelligence information. The information provided by Marwan, you have explained who he was, during the first days of September, when he met Zvika Zamir in Rome, was that Sadat would not initiate war in 73. Both King Hussein, 2 weeks, even less, before the war, and Ashraf Rabban on the last day, and state that political steps could prevent the war. The inability to hold on to the front line and other military difficulties did not stem from the failure of the advance warning. The Suez Canal line was not a defensive line, but rather a political line, as you have said, to put the flag. The failure of the Israeli intelligence, which estimated low probability of war, had a little influence on the decision-making of Dayan and Meir. The conduct and actions of Golda Meir and Dayan in the days preceding the war were based on political consideration. A, I have already explained, so that goal was political, and therefore there was low probability that he would attack. They attempt to encourage calm in order to avoid calling up the reserve and arousing an escalation of tension just before the election. They attempt to encourage calm so Kissinger would not initiate political moves and not remember the commitment. Wait longer than 2 hours. In Israel, they were certain of the results of the war, no doubt about it, if it didn't break out. But Meir and Dayan did not want war to break out in October. Their messages to the United States and to the Army Chief of Staff, and I can add it to the journalist, to the press, remain calm. Even the final moments before the war, on Saturday, Yom Kippur, Meir, Dayan, and Galili preferred quite diplomatic steps to prevent it, rather than proper military deployment. And the last one, even if a proper warning, as they hope to have, as they have the illusion to have, had been received, approval to call up the reserves and move them to the front would not have been given. Approval for preventive air force attack would not have been given.